K-State and KU first started playing football, they first started in 1902, and we won the first four or five games. In 1906, K-State won the game, and then they didn't beat us. They tied us a couple of times, but they didn't beat us again until 1924. I was a freshman that year, and a boy named Meek, Kansas State, picked up a fumble and ran the whole length of the field for a touchdown, and they beat us 6-0. That's the first time they'd beaten us in about 14 or 15 years. After that, we didn't beat them until 1928. Not the 4 years I was in school, we didn't beat them once. In 1944, we lost over there in a game that has hurt me more than any other game where I've ever coached. We had the ball on the last down of the game. We went into punt formation because it was fourth and about 10 yards to go. And Charlie Moffett, our quarterback, ran through the whole Kansas State team with some blocking ahead of him and scored a touchdown. One of our players was going down the field. He'd already blocked two men and was trying to catch up with the K-State player. And the K-State player, this fella was behind him and ran into his back, and it called a clipping penalty. So it was a 15-yard penalty on us, and we lost the ball game.
Don't go walking down Lover's Lane with anyone else but me.
The one I remember best is 1955. Bus Mertes is the K-State coach and Chuck Mather, the coach at KU. The game is at Memorial Stadium in Lawrence. The pregame prognostication had all clubs ranked even. But in the middle of the week, a veterinarian student who was on about the third string defensive end for Kansas State happened to catch something on the KU film where they noticed that John Francisco, the halfback for KU, was giving the plays away. When the play went left, his toes would point left. When the play went right, his toes would point right, and he would go into a straightaway crouch position if it were going to be a pass play. Well, as a result, K-State knew exactly what KU was doing on every play of the game, and it was one of K-State's most lopsided wins by a score of 46-0.
Gives to Francisco. Tries to go wide. Rather shoots the gap, jars Francisco loose from the ball, and six Wildcats fall on the pigskin. That ended KU's main scoring threat of the afternoon and gave K-State a startling 46-0 win. Biggest margin for the Wildcats in the 53-year-old series.
So in my travels around the state, the fans talk about the KU K-State game, and everybody wants those bragging rights. Most of the games have been pretty good. The thing I really remember about through the years is not the individual games, but the great players who have played in it.
Well, I hope you enjoy that excellent documentary there of this fine series here between Kansas and Kansas State. And down on the field now, the KSU band performing under the direction of Stanley E. Fink and the field direction by drum majors Julie Compton, Roger Wetter, and Jeff Pennington. The Kansas State University Marching Band.